Hey everyone, Christian here from CK Wraps. So today we're going to do the hood on this Mustang in Vivid's new satin red chrome. This is a much more pliable chrome. It's a lot thinner. It's probably at least a quarter of the thickness of the old stuff, so it's going to be super easy to conform. What we've done here already is we've prepped the surface with isopropyl alcohol. We've used some tack reducer. I've shown that in other videos where I apply tack reducer on the really flat areas, not in the recesses and not over bumps, but in the really flat areas, leaving about 3 to 4 inches from all the edges. So we've done that, we've taken a compressor, we've blown away all the contaminants. The rest of the car has been prepped, bumpers are off, stuff like that. We'll most likely remove the headlights still, and the vents are out as well. So the reason why I like to use the compressor around here, especially once we remove the vents, there's going to be dust and stuff under there. It's really hard to clean properly because of how many intricate areas there are inside of there. So that's been done. We've made sure there's no dust that's going to be drawn in. Now there are imperfections in the hood that I want you to see. Especially with it being the front of the car, there's going to be stone chips. And on top of that, there's imperfections in the manufacturer's paint. I have found one that I can just point out to you. If we can get focused in on that. So you're going to have to hit it with the, there you go, it's right there. So that is painted over, okay? That is not a stone chip, that is just painted over in black. So I just wanted you to see that. There are always imperfections in the paints. Maybe if it's a Ferrari or something a little more exotic, there won't be. But on a regular car that's manufactured and put out thousands and thousands and thousands of them, there's going to be imperfections in the paint. They're not perfect. And that could be on the mirrors, the fenders, hood, roof, wherever, doors, that kind of stuff. So on top of that, there are stone chips, and they're very noticeable. They're here, they're all over. Those are not as predominant when we wrap over them. They might show through a little bit, but it will depend on the film that you're using. Gloss chrome, satin chrome, or just regular matte or regular satin or gloss materials. So and each color shade will show it a little bit differently. As we wrap over something like that, we're adding a layer on top of that, so it tends to show a little bit more. So we'll get to it right now. I already have the piece cut. So this is the infamous hood that's larger than 60 inches in all directions, okay? So from this end to this end, it's larger than 60 inches. We could seam this, but I don't want to seam this. I want to do this in one piece. And this will be very few in the world with a one-piece chrome hood wrap, okay? A lot of installers are not using 60-inch chrome just because they prefer to use Avery at 48 inches or Hexis at 54 inches or whatever, 56 inches. So Vivid's comes 60 inches, which brings us about half an inch or 3/4 of an inch shy of this corner up here. So mainly what I'm going to do is I'm going to position this film closest to the edge down here. It's going to come a little bit short up here, but there's going to be less stretching involved as opposed to having it short down here, where I have to stretch the whole bottom piece. There's only a small corner over here that we're going to have to gradually bring out a little bit further. So let me get this piece on top. On top of this, this car's front end is not magnetic, okay? The hood, the front fenders are not magnetic. So I throw that on there, and I have a mark in this film. I have to cut a new piece. So there's an actual dent in it right there, and I have no idea why. So I'll show you that. There's a hole there, I can see the backing paper through it. I can use some of this film, I'll probably use it for the trunk, it's not a big deal. But that looks like it came from the manufacturer because I've already trimmed off about a foot from the very end of the roll. Not a problem, we're going to put this away for now. All right. Oh yes, on top of this, sorry, it's really hard to handle when I'm doing it like this. On top of that, this has a brand new backing paper, okay? This is a much softer feeling backing paper. It's a little more waxy. You can see it has a bit of a sheen on it. It says Vivid Premium Plus on the back, or Premium Series on the back. And it doesn't kind of recoil like the other backing papers do on their current film. So all their new products are going to have this backing paper on it, which makes it a lot easier to use. Let me get this out of the way for now. I'm going to cut a new piece. Hopefully, there's no more damage in it. Let's just stick it over here. Grab a couple more magnets. So what I've done is I've cut this, because this is going to be 60 inches no matter what, I'm cutting it 74 inches across. So I've got four magnets here. What I like to do is lay it out on the car. I'm going to grab the snitty. So in case you don't remember what a snitty is, I showed this in another video. That's your snitty right there. These come in all different colors, brands, stuff like that. Avery makes their own, Mater, Martyr makes theirs. But this is called a snitty. Makes it really easy and safe to cut near the paint. Now you don't want to rub it on the paint. Still you want to try and keep it away, but the blade is protected. All right, so I'm going to roll this out, arms width. Get a magnet down there too. Make sure that doesn't fall. We're gonna need to measure it. So I have this handy measuring tape that's magnetic. The door is magnetic, so I can stick that near the end. I want the inches side. There we go. Markings on the vacuum paper make it really easy to cut straight. Okay. Hopefully, there's no more damage in this. I don't see any. All right, now that that's good, we can get back to doing what we were doing. Let's put that there, these magnets here. Perfect, all right. So again, we're gonna kind of get this up and on, like so. We gotta line it up, all right? That's the important part. So I'm gonna show you how short we are on these corners over here. It's probably about an inch. Just let me get it lined up here. All we need is about a quarter of an inch here, okay? We don't need a lot more. I'm covering up here somehow. I'm covering the top of the hood here, which means I'm not straight yet. The straighter I can make it across, the less that I'll have to stretch these two ends right here. All right. I'm gonna bring it a little bit more this way. And I'm just looking at the evenness on that corner over there and this corner over here. And we're gonna double check that. We've got about 3/4 of an inch. So I'm going to just peel, without moving this, peel the backing slightly and stick it to the car, because I don't want this moving at all when I go to peel the backing paper off. It needs to be very accurate. All right, so if Christina wants to come around and show you just kind of how shy I am on these corners over here. So we can see we've got about 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch to cover this, okay? We can take, once we get this down right here, we can take some stretch and bring it a bit this way. So we can soften the film and bring it, and it should be totally fine. Now, doing this with a regular film, like a regular gloss or a regular matte or satin, is gonna be much easier to stretch that little bit that you need right there, okay? So again, I'm just gonna make sure that we're tacked down there. And I'm gonna start removing the backing on this side because I'm right-handed and it just feels right. So again, we're peeling the sticker side off first and then rolling the backing paper. I'm gonna be very gentle because I don't want it to come off that side. And we're gonna lead out as far as we can go. Oh, this backing paper is super nice, guys. I have to say, like, it's a It's a treat. It's a nice upgrade. So I'm just going to place that there and stick it to the fender side. Keep this corner up. And we're going to keep it rolling, all right? We want to keep it as smooth as possible. That way it's kind of already glossed. Perfect. We get this out of the way. What's important here is that we don't rip it off the ends, okay? We have to be very gentle. I'm gonna come, since I have the two top corners tacked down a bit. Oh, it's not good. All right, we're fine. All right. So I was gonna come through the front first, but that's fine. I'll do this area. Make sure we're still covered here. Okay, we're good. So we're just getting this evened out, all right? What I can do is create a bracket. This film is also, I've been told, very resilient to scratches. So it should be nearly flawless after we're done installing it. I'm not gonna use any soap and water, but I am not gonna test its resiliency to scratches at this moment. But I'm pretty confident it feels really nice. So this kind of stuff, guys, is only at the time available for installation through us. So if you wanted something, we have a whole brand new line of satin combs. You can see them on the back wall there. All different colors, pretty much something for anyone's need. Whatever you're looking for, golds, lime, whatever, green, Tiffany, we have it all. All right, so I'm just gonna gloss this out a little bit more now that I kind of have it hinged in the middle. Remember, there's tack producer on this, so we have to still be gentle because there isn't a lot of grab. I don't really want to take it past the halfway point. I'm going to do that again. All right, very easy to stretch. This kind of stuff just makes me happy because it brings installing chrome to a whole other level. Doing this hood in one piece, for example, is one of those levels. Gotta still be careful here. We're gonna get any wrinkles in there. We gotta be careful. So we're keeping our squeegee, we're overlapping our strokes a little bit at a time, about an inch or so. And we're gonna bring this out. I'm gonna bring this out a little bit more here. Glass that, all right. See how I'm pulling this way? That's what I want. Again, it's still a heat-activated adhesive. So what we need to do here is find, we're gonna bridge this a little bit here. It's not a huge recess. I should grab my rack glove, 2 seconds. always something. All right, I don't even have to add any heat, guys. All right. So we're getting air buildup right here. All we need to do is lift it a little bit. Okay. We'll keep a little tension on it, just so I can keep things even, and get that out right there. All right. So you'll notice that I've worked this recess before working. I still have air over here, and I haven't forgotten about it. I can see it pretty clearly. We're gonna work that slowly because we want the air to release, and we don't want to cause a wrinkle. Cool. Same idea here. No heat on this, like it's just going in really nicely. Now the air is releasing itself out that end there. I can help it just a little bit if I lift it. All right. You can come over the top just slightly. And we're gonna bring this out a little bit more. Need to glass it. Not to bridge this gap if I don't have to. I want to lay it in. The center one is a little bit more difficult. We're going to create a little bit of slack. All right, that's enough. Making sure it's pretty smooth, okay, before we start squeezing any of this down. Keeping tension on the film will keep wrinkles away. All right. We still want to lay it in where we can. So we're keeping enough tension on the film to kind of keep the wrinkles away. But at the same time, letting it fall into its place. Once we get this recess down far enough, we're going to take the film and glass it out again. There's a vent hole right there. I'm going to take this and start working out this way and out this way now. I got my triangles, okay? These are my triangles. So we had a lot of excess film around that vent. We need to come up a little bit past here and then spread it out, okay? A little bit more. I don't know if that's going to be good enough yet. I have to add a little more tension. I'm not getting sticking there, I'm not getting my wrinkles spread out enough. the way I want them to. There we go, okay? See, that's where you want. You want this part done and smoothed out. We can work this afterwards, all right? Get that out of my pocket. So, let's work this over this way. And as we get closer to the end, we're going to start stretching it a little bit, okay? I want you to even this out. I'm gonna add a touch of heat across so that I can get this corner to make it over here, all right? So let me grab the heat gun. Testing the heat on my arm, seeing how hot we are. Super close, all right? It's kind of just where we want it. So the car is blocked, the corner is going to come around really tight and nice, and it should be fine. I can actually take a little bit more and stretch it over a little bit, so I'm going to bring this back just a bit, add another millimeter or two. There's no recoil on it, so it means we're not overstretched right now. Now it's going to be nice and tight around that corner, all right? So you might think that I have too much tension around here. Well, what we need to do is, before we cut, is fold it around a little bit more and release the tension here and here and fold it around a little bit more and then shrink it around that corner. Okay, so I'm going to start working this down a little bit. I wanted these wrinkles a little bit closer to the edge, it makes it easier. And now, do that. I'm not gonna go too far over here yet because I'm gonna end up pulling a little bit past and then glassing it out more this way once we work on the other side. Go roughly halfway, just keeping the film up so we can keep the wrinkles out and a little bit of tension on it. We're almost there. This is going to be a bit more of a challenging section over here. So we have to, we're going to get excess film right here in this area. So we need to even out the wrinkles somehow. What we need to do is gloss it out a little bit and then create a little bit of tension, squeegee some of it, and then release the film and let it relax again. I'm gonna add a bit of heat. Pull down this way. All right, like I said, I want it to gloss it out a little bit. Squeegee some of that, all right? Get that right there. Let's get that down a little bit. So I don't want to bridge this gap too much, somewhere around there. I'm going to even this out here while I'm here. Try to keep things even and consistent. Even that line out. All right. Now, I should be able to alleviate some of that tension. And a lot of my wrinkles have gone away. Pull that down into there. Keep my hands behind the outside so my hands are not actually under the hood. Keep a little bit of tension on it. All right. Try to keep this even out again. Putting firm, even pressure. And you can see how I'm squeegeeing it, right, guys? I'm not pushing down on it like this. It's not a good idea. We're cutting across, always cutting across. I'm gonna add a little heat. I need to spread it out a little bit, all right? Keep that tension there again. Get some of those out. Getting there. Finish off this corner. Then keep my hand behind it and then just kind of lay it in there really nicely. Awkward because it dips down and in, throws a lot of things off. It's a pretty intricate hood. It's not that flat and that easy. Working it a little bit at a time. We're getting a lot of fingering there, but that's fine. I'm not overstretching it. I'm just working it out. A little bit at a time, all right? Keeping my hands on the exterior and kind of spreading apart with my fingers like this. Okay? So I have my hands behind it just like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's get this part finished up over here, then we'll move on to the other side. I'm just looking at the tension that we have. Just looking at all the tension that we have right here. I want to relax it a little bit. I need to get rid of this guy right there. Now I can keep all that nice and relaxed. Let's draw some tension out here. Don't cut the paint, okay? Let's relax that. Start squeezing my mouth, try not to do that. We can work in this area with our finger. Makes it a little bit easier. And we can draw that tension off right there so we can finish that up afterwards when we start doing all our cutting, all right? So that is one side all done. Just gonna go over this, all right? It's much easier to do with a glove on. I'm just too lazy to put the glove on right now. Making sure we're all good there. All right, let's get on to the other side. So as we work from one side to the other, we learn a couple of things. It may go a little bit easier, and it may go completely different, just because we're working in a different direction with our hands. So we always try to learn what we can from one side when we move on to the other side. That way it makes things a little bit easier. All right. I'm gonna get that fixed up right there. So what I wanna do is lift all this up. Pull a little bit more from the middle. Fine, I can get this out if I just take my time. I'm trying to work these guys out right here to all this over here. All right, I'm being a little more gentle with the squeegee. I'm not pushing too hard. I just wanted to get that fixed up though. Push down on that bubble. Let's get it out of there. All right, let's even that out. Perfect. Oh. Kind of taking care of all this slack that was here in the middle. I get this down a little bit more like this. Okay. Again, our wrinkles run across, all right? Now, pull down. Let's get that air release going. Perfect. We gotta do that recess right there. Just grab my glove, just on the floor, make sure it's not dusty. So I don't even see a single buffer or swirl mark or anything in this film. Even with the monkey strips on my buffer, on any kind of chrome or gloss or whatever, we always get some kind of swirl mark. They usually post heat out, but there's nothing on this at all. I don't see anything. So I actually don't need to use any heat, I forgot. We have the high and the low points again, guys, all right? We're gonna work in the low point. And that's just how we do it. I need to create a bit of relief here. I haven't actually squeegeed down here yet. Just keep an eye on this as we go, because you can see there's slack, so we have to be careful that we don't get any bunching up of the film. When it comes to getting all the air, I'm going to work it that way instead this time, because I seem to have a bit more tension down here. Find that air channel, find where all of that area where that needs to be squeegeed down. And work it a bit at a time, working out that end. If we have a spot on the ends of the panel, it allows us to squeegee a little bit faster, all right? Because the air is really releasing a lot faster. If we go too quickly and the air is blocked off at the ends, you could risk bunching up of material and then getting a wrinkle. That's not a problem if you have a gloss or a matte finish to install and it's, you can heal it up really easily and shrink it all back, but with chrome, you only really get one shot. So you get a wrinkle in chrome and it's usually permanent. So I'm gonna keep that elevated and get that finished up. Some air right there. Then we're going to try and lay into this recess here. We're going to go over the top slightly, round it all out, and just kind of even it out before we stretch the film too far. This hand under here. That part came up again, that's not a problem, we'll put it back down. But this is kind of the way it wants to go, so this is the way we're gonna do it. Too much pressure here. Difficult part about this is it keeps wanting touch here and it's adding tension to this area over here. So you have to kind of keep getting it up and over this edge. Bad wrinkle. No damage to the film, which is good. I was worried about that for a second. We got that laid into the recess. We got to fix it up a little bit here. A little tension on that. Perfect. I want to take it. Here's the vent again. Pull it back just a little bit past there. And I'm gonna learn from the other side, and I wanna gloss it right over top of that whole thing if I can. We'll make it a little bit easier. Should be okay here. Let's see if I push down here. We're adding a bit of tension. And get that air out of here. Just work it slowly. And we're good. All right. So repositioning the film is really important. You can see that I reposition it often, all right? And that's the reason why I use the tack reducer, is to alleviate stress on the chrome. It's mostly just for chrome that I use it for. I don't use it for anything else, but it creates a lot less stress on the chrome when I'm going to reposition it. Draw. Not quite ready for that. I'm getting too much fingering over here. So we gotta get a little bit closer. This side is actually sitting a lot closer to this corner right now. I only have maybe quarter of an inch to stretch the film. See right there. So we're good. We're gonna have enough to go around, and we're gonna be good. We're gonna be nice and tight on that corner. Even all this out right up to the edge. Oh, there's some air there. Nope. Get that going again. Perfect. Same deal on this side again. We're gonna have to bridge the gap a little bit, get it ironed out, and then release it all. So that way I draw the slack outwards. Just kind of get that leveled off. The fingering is getting pretty intense right here. I'm gonna fix that up again. Level it all out. I should be a little, there's gonna be some, but we should be able to do quite a bit with this right now. Try laying it in there. Still a little too much, so we can see that the fingering is accumulating. We need to stop that from getting too severe, especially on the chrome. I'm gonna keep my hand under it with a bit of tension on it. There isn't much of a recess, so it's not too bad. Over here it's worse, so we have to take more care when we're laying it in. A little bit of heat again. And now it's just kind of glassing it out because it's pretty flat right now. That's pretty flat right there. There's not much bridging of a recess here. I can lift this up again here. Squeegee that into there. All right. Work these out this way. Gentle. Keeping that tension up with my hand behind it, but not under where I'm squeegeeing. I'm just on the outside of it. I need just a touch of heat here. Just trying to spread them out. Got a little bit too much bunching up here. It's not a big deal. We're gonna work it out. Just a little bit at a time, all right? Close one there. There we go. Get ourselves down here. Use my finger right there. There we go. Let's get it going. So it's really, like I said, awkward in this recess because it's just not really right for a squeegee.
good. I want to make sure we're down everywhere here. All right, that's pretty much that. Whew. It's hot. I gotta fix this up here. One sec. And the other side also. Perfect. Make sure everything's good. All right, looks awesome. I'm gonna go over these edges right now. Want to even everything out. Go around here. We don't have to go too nuts with laying it too far into here. We just want to make sure that we have full coverage. All right, so we had an interruption there. So we're going to do this side as well. I'm just going to add a little bit of heat. This. All right, so I need to create some leaf cuts. Let's get some of this off the wipers because it's causing issues with getting it down properly. All right. You don't want to cut the wipers, so be careful. Let's do this now. Back of the blade on the fender. All right. I'm gonna come straight down. Come off and out. Some spots. I'm gonna get that piece entirely out of the way. Once we do the hood, once we pop the hood, we're gonna do the front. So I want to get this down and around really nicely. We don't have to go very far, we just gotta come around a little bit. It's gonna help it along. It kind of just holds itself to that edge there. And this gets rid of some of this slack here on the corner. Got a little bit too much. Sorry if I'm in the way. I gotta see what I'm doing though. I know you wanna see. Okay, add a little heat. Perfect. It's going to be pretty when it's all done. What I do is I just go pretty evenly with my finger. Make sure there's no tension. Pretty evenly across. That way when we cut on the back side, it's very even. All right. I'll start cutting on the back side while the hood is closed. Work our way out. I'm gonna create tension as we get nearer to the end. Okay, perfect. We'll go about halfway or so. leave that. Once I pop the hood, I'll tuck all this in also. Let's move around to the other side. Again, I need a relief cut somewhere around here. I lift it up so I don't cut the wipers. Add a bit of heat again. And get this contoured around here. Just like that. Again, run your fingers down evenly. And it'll create a nice straight edge, all right? So one of the ways that I like to do nice corners, guys, is when I do a corner, I cut the film in a circular motion. I don't cut it off straight at a point. Always cut it around the corner. So when we go to put the film around the corner, we're not trying to shape a square to a circle. We're trying to shape a circle to a circle. So because the corners are round. And that will make it much easier. The less film that you have around your corners, the easier it is going to be to make them look nice. We don't need a lot of film around the edge, around the corners. As long as we're not overstretching and you give it a little post heat, you're good. I'm gonna go over all of it with a post heat afterwards. Just going to come up in here. Okay, now if you want to switch spots, I'll come down this side. Where did I start there? I lost my sight. Right around here. Hold this out and come off. I hold it out so I don't cut the headlight. If you remove the headlights prior to doing that, then you don't have to worry. All right, go over that corner a little bit. I'm gonna go over this. I'm gonna go over it a little bit also before I open the hood. Pop it. It's completely closed right now. Somewhere around here. All right. So this gives us access. We can see a lot easier. We can finish off all these edges around this side. So I'm going to work them a little bit at a time. I'm not going over it the entire way with my finger. I'm just working it around a little bit at a time, all right? Just kind of where I'll do a bit of post heating at the same time. I'm not bringing my post heat temperature up to 180, 190, I'm just sealing it all off, and that's it. So like I said, the less film that we have on the corners, the easier it is to do the corners. almost there. I finished this off. I'm going to go a little bit excess on the front of the hood because people grab it all the time. And we're good. We're going to cut that off. And that's going to be it. Other than cutting the vents out, which I'm not even going to bother with, you can just cut them out yourself. I'm going to do them, but I mean, what I mean, cut them out yourself. You can. It's an easy one to figure out. So again, when we're cutting, I have the blade, the back of the blade on the side of the hood. And I'm adding a little tension to the film to create an even cut. Gonna give it some slack here. All right. Now you can see that I have about 3/4 of an inch or so that I'm cutting off from the very front. It means we probably may not even have had to stretch out the corners a little bit towards the windshield if we place this a little bit better. It's, for me, it's not really worth the risk. I would rather not come up short on the edge of the hood and come up short on those corners because I was expecting to. I planned for it. All right, we're gonna go over that with some heat. On the corners, I like to push down and in, okay? Down and in. That way they come out really nice. And that's it. So if Christina wants to go over all the edges, she'll show you how straight they are and how nice the corners look. Even though we won't be able to see the underside at all once the hood's closed. So, but every corner around its point here looks magnificent. And that edge is nice and straight, all right? So I'll close the hood and we'll have a look at it. Like I said, I'm not gonna do the vents. It's just a simple matter of cutting them out. You guys should already be well on your way as far as cutting these guys out, though. Won't be a problem. Just make sure we're not cutting on the paint again. Cut in the gaps. All right. So that's how we do the hood, guys. That's in satin red chrome. It may be the only one or one of the very first Mustang hoods done in chrome in one piece. Since this is a 60-inch chrome and this hood is pretty much a little bit larger than 60 inches in all directions. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to see more, please subscribe. We're doing a whole bunch more on the Mustang, and it's going to look pretty awesome when it's all done. We're going to do an entire overlook once it's all finished up. Thanks, everyone. Take care.